What do you want for me to be for you tonight, honey? A good girl? Bad girl? You like it rough?
You are such a tramp.
If you can't please your man, you shouldn't be allowed to have one.
There's no way these girls are from our school, man.
I would jump that.
I heard it's your birthday today.
Yeah, big 1-8.
Put me out. I do not see what he sees in her.
My brother wants this to go well tonight. If you make me look bad, you two won't live to regret it.
Where is the weed?
Don't even trip, relax.
Within each of us lies the ability to do great good or great evil.
Do you want some?
What is it?
Make you feel really good.
I don't know.
Dude, they're dead.
What are you talking about?
They are upstairs, covered in blood. It's a curse.
There's no curse. Oh my God.
Please don't leave me, Kyle.
Get out of here, Rachel.
This is not a joke.
It's not too late to turn around and run out of this house.
Now we can finally be together, Serena.
ION Entertainment. ION Entertainment.
Okay, we're here with Randy Aldridge. He's the producer of The Devil Within.
Yes, I am.
Sounds like a great movie. Now tell us how you got involved with this project.
Well, we did our first movie that was called Unseen. It was a skateboard movie filmed in Hollywood. And then after that, we decided to go up a little higher, and we did the movie called Disturbed. And that was a horror movie about Mason escapes from prison to get revenge on a family. And that was a lot of fun to do. I learned a lot from that. And then I went to school with our director and Matt Dean, who was the writer. Mm-hmm. He was part of the group that bought Disturbed. So I had connections with everyone. And I said, you know what? I've got this movie in mind I want to do. And I told Matt, you know, my highlights. And then Matt, the genius he is, he just wrote a great script. So when you have all these sins and everything involved, and you know what these high school kids, and they do these sins and then they die, and then we had a handicapped girl, and we thought, what would it be like to have a handicapped girl running in Hollywood in the alleys at 3 a.m. with a killer, and we don't know who the killer is, but you know, chasing with this big butcher knife, and this poor girl can barely walk, and she's having to have to be chased. So there was a little more to just the high school, the good-looking girls, and this, and then with Bill Oberst Jr. playing the principal, we were in awe of how well he did. He brought a creepiness that was just so good, and the way the energy was on the set, we really enjoyed each other. We had fun. We made sure everyone was comfortable because, you know, one thing is when you're it's expensive. So you're trying to get as much as you can get done as fast as you can. But you also want them to have fun. You want to treat them well. You know, I just felt like we were all the same. I didn't feel like I was an executive producer. I felt like, you know, I had to clean the motorhome one time because no one else can do it. So I had no problem doing it. But it turned into something. And then we started getting some really good music in the movie. And then when we started adding all this and really fine-tuning the editing, I personally think it's a really cute movie. And that was our goal, just get something. When you rent a movie or you watch a movie, you either feel like you got ripped off or you feel like, oh, I'm glad I rented it. You know, it was cute. And so we tried to give a little bit of everything to everyone that would enjoy the movie, plus have some sort of backstory where if you are a good person, and the devil within, meaning, you know, the least among us is the handicapped girl that God will always take care of, the people that can't defend themselves. So there's some things in there, and it really works well. And I was just thrilled with this cast. I think this cast, watch this now and then give it a couple of years and see where these guys are. They're getting a lot of work, and they're just a lot of talent. They're just raw talent that people just haven't seen yet. And once they get with these guys, they're going to see how well they're going to do in their careers.
It must be really a good feeling to give so many talented people their start on your movie.
And you know what? And they gave me the 110%. So what was great about it is, you know, you invest a lot of money. This was a lot of money for me. It was all my money. So for them to give 110%, anything I asked of them, they showed up. They never complained. They were just so easy to deal with, and that's why I was able to, there was a lot of energy on the set, and everybody was encouraging everyone else. And then as you start to meet these people, you realize how sweet they are, how talented they are, and I got them for nothing, basically, you know, and they were willing to do it, and the love of the art, you know, making a movie is actually kind of fun to make something and go, look what we all did. You know, because it took everyone to make this, and that was the most satisfying thing for my wife and I. I mean, we just looked at it and said, wow, I can't wait for the next one, you know.
What were you doing before you decided to make the skateboard film with your son?
I own a plastics company, and I do sell to all the studios, so I knew kind of what was going on and everything.
And that's why you could be your principal investor then.
Exactly, and that's what pays for everything. And so as you get off the ground, it's a little tough. Once I made money on Disturbed, it was easy to go in and go, look, now I know, you know, it's show business, it's easy to make the show, and then you've got the business in that most people have no clue. So they make
it seems like it's been really easy for you. I mean, you just started out with one movie, and then all of a sudden it's like you've got The Devil Within.
Yeah, I got three. I got The Unseen, Disturbed, The Devil Within, and then there's more to that. It makes it sound easy, but one thing you've learned, it's business, and I tell people, look, we're easy to do business with. And once they see the movie, it was pretty easy to sell it. And that's why it'll be in all the stores. I mean, we were shocked how the pre-orders alone, that means someone put out their credit card, ordered the movie, and they're gonna wait 2 to 3 weeks to get their movie. I was flabbergasted how many we sold, you know, pre-orders. So that was a big deal for all the big stores. And so when the big stores could see it, they were like, okay, we're on board. We're gonna, you know, go on with this, and we haven't even started foreign sales yet. This is just domestic.
Well, where can we find The Devil Within? Where can we buy it?
The end of the month, we have Walmart, which will be our largest, and then Target, and then we'll have Best Buy, Barnes & Noble, which I didn't even know they sold DVDs, and they have it. Amazon's been huge, and hotmovies.com, and I'm sure I'm forgetting a few others. So just to see it on the shelf, I'm bringing a camera crew, and I'm going to go look, and I'm going to have a Walmart employee with me, and I'm going to be pulling the movie off the shelf, because that's my dream. It's not the money. It's to be able that we followed through on something, and we did it. And that's what's important. So the next movie we do, which might be a sequel, we'll bring as many people as we can back that are still alive, and we can, we'll find a part for them. If it's a teacher, you know, if it's something, we'll figure it out and use them, because I have that much feeling for the cast. The cast and crew were just unbelievable.
But then you have to put her in your next movie then.
Absolutely.
Okay, well, thank you so much for spending time with us. We can't wait to see The Devil Within. It sounds like a great movie.
Great. Excellent. Thank you.
ION Entertainment. ION Entertainment.